from school.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went from there. My mum was always up in Angaston.
Yep.
And I was with a sister, her auntie, we lived there, and I used to go up and stay with mum on holidays and whatever. And then mum married, and so I went up there, but I would have been in grade 7.
Grade 7? Yep. And what year was that?
Oh, God. I was born in 1927. I was in grade 7.
Okay.
Oh, wait a minute, no, I'd be older than that. I was only 7 years old.
No, that's right,
13. 1934. 14.
Okay.
I was about 14.
Okay.
13 to 14.
Yep.
In my 14th year. Angaston School was terrific. I mean, I can remember some of the people I can remember. There was the Raisers.
Yes.
The Bohms, Esther Bohm, and what was this? There was her brother, Clarence Healy. Clarence died some years back. There was a beautiful girl there, but she was a bit out of my will. She was a clever girl, but she was Dowitz's. They were the builders of Angaston.
All right, Dowitz's.
Yeah,
okay.
Rhonda Dowitz, she was a beautiful girl.
Yeah.
I admired her from a distance.
All right. Well, she might have seen some of your behaviour.
I don't know that I should tell you this one, but I think his name was Jennings. He was a teacher up there. He was our teacher, grade 7, that's right.
Right.
Bill. And he stayed at the Angaston pub. That's the one up further.
Yeah.
And
down the bottom of the main street? Is that the one on the corner?
No, the one towards, going towards the east. He was our teacher. He was quite a good teacher. He was quite a good bloke.
Yeah.
I think he was. In those days, we thought he was old, naturally.
Yeah.
Now
he's really old.
He was 39 mark, 40 mark.
Yeah.
And I don't think he was married because I think he stayed at the hotel.
Okay.
And he must have gone for a leak, you see, before he left school. And we had some boys in our class, I can tell you. Anyway, especially Warren. What was his name? Warren. Anyway, he stuttered. So when the car sat down and we're there, he gets up and says, hey, Warren, sit down. Hey, please, sir. Warren, if you don't sit down, I'll send you outside. He said, well, sir, you better do your fly up. Kids burst out laughing, and the poor chappy, he went as red as beef, and shot out the parts like a. And everybody's done it.
Yeah.
You know, but this bloody Warren, he deliberately did it, you know. I mean, but Warren, he did it deliberately. And none of us knew he was going to do it.
Yeah.
And none of us knew he had his fly open. But he did.
So you think the principal was happy to see the back of you when you left?
I don't think he worried him too much.
Warren sounded like he was a bit of a rat bag too.
Oh, yeah, he was. He was quite a nice bloke, Warren, but he just couldn't resist it. He couldn't try to go out and tell him, whisper in his ear. He had to yell it out.
Excuse me, sir, your fly's undone.
That's right.
How many kids were in the school at that point? Can you remember? Wait, the classes at least.
Oh, there'd have to be a couple of hundred. There'd have to be.
A couple of hundred kids.
Yeah, there were 7 classes. It was full 7 classes, I think, all of it. And you take an average 30 in a class.
Yep.
So there's 210. So they'd be in the 200 mark.
Okay.
See, they've bred a bit better since we left.
Yeah, better rainfall. So.
Yeah, and we never had an actual football side nor a cricket side.
We
went to different schools to play.
Right. Yeah.
But as you know, the yard's very big there, and down where there used to be all those pine trees the back.
Well, it's changed a lot now.
I haven't been around there for a while. I've gone down to see Trevor, but I've never gone around that way. But we used to play kick the pit footy down the bottom of the yard
mm-hmm.
and play cricket down that yard.
Yeah.
And I'll never forget, I don't know where we got it from, it was an old bat, and all the binding had come off it, so you could get the bat in shape. But boy, you could hit a cricket ball. And we used to play, well, we put the glass and window, the people lived just down the, and we put the ball through their window, and they wasn't very happy, he come charging up.
Tell me about the band. You said you were a drummer in the band?
Oh, that was only a school band, you know, the yep. Fife and all that. There was yep. nothing particular.
Since we don't have the Fife band or anything, we've got some old pictures. I'll show you some pictures afterwards.
But, no, we were just there with about three or four playing flutes, you know, the flute.
Yep.
And I had the kettle drum.
Right.
That was a kettle drum.
Kettle drums are more of a high drum,
bass drum, you know. Yeah. And I used to have to sing it, announce what we were going to play while they asked me to score.
Right. Did you have the loudest voice?
Yeah. We're now playing Bonnie Mary of a Child. Fowler, it's Mary, not Mary. Every time I said
good to see you.
He was little short chap, he was.
This is the principal. Was it Snyder?
Snyder. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Can you remember his first name?
Oh, no, I can't really. I was too proper to find out his proper name. He had a son, Don, and there was a daughter. She was the elder of the two. Don was quite a nice fellow.
Don Snyder.
Yeah.
In terms of, we refer to it as pedagogy now, the delivery of the education in the classroom, most of the knowledge came directly from the teacher?
Absolutely. Oh, yes. He would have to prepare. I would imagine, but I don't know, but I would think when you have the teachers have their holidays, those teachers would have to provide their curriculum for the next 12 months
yep.
for teaching.
Yep.
I mean, they'd have to. They'd have to have it all laid out, you know, what was going to be. That's how it was presented to you. You know?
How did you record information down and what was teaching like back then?
Oh, it's all by pencil. I mean, it's all by word of mouth. The blackboard was either written on there, that sort of thing. There's nothing like this.
Yeah.
No such thing, nothing like this at all.
So blackboard,
verbatim sort of thing, you know. And you'd have to write down in your book what your homework was, you know, and all this type of thing.
Did you have many textbooks to work with, or was
from
the teacher?
Yes, you had your reader, you had your primer, you had your copybook.
What's your primer?
Well, that was your book you read stories out of.
Okay.
You know, that started off at early in your. But then you had your history book, you had your geography book, you had your arithmetic book, it had all your arithmetics from that. As I said, your copybook writing, you had to learn how to improve my writing, I can tell you. Some had atlases, you know.
Yep.
But there was quite a variety of books you had. I know they were glad to get rid of it.